I will be preparing a sanctions package for the court.
He was armed with a court order, which he thought he could play games with.
That shows that the two of you will never agree on anything.
The judge in the case against Casey Anthony hoping for a much smoother morning after court came to a halt within the first hour yesterday.
No witnesses were ever called, and the jury never even set foot inside the courtroom. Andrea Jackson is live at the WESH 2 Courthouse studio.
And Andrea, Judge Belvin Perry seemed exasperated by the fight that was going on with the two lead attorneys.
Good morning, Sion and Aixa. I think Judge Pellin Perry has pretty much had it at this point. Day 23 in the case against Casey ended almost as quickly as it began.
That shows that the two of you will never agree on anything and will never interpret anything the same way.
This comment after Judge Belvin Perry asked both attorneys to tell him what time it was and making it clear their differences will most likely have to be resolved by the Florida bar and court violations would be handled at the end of the trial.
I will be preparing a sanctions package for the court because, again, this is, another deliberate violation of the court's order.
He sat and decided not to take a deposition. He wants to go after her lawyer, too. And I think it is repulsive.
Judge Perry's orders regarding disclosure of expert witness testimony were set up to prevent both sides from ambushing each other with surprise witnesses.
This court does not make threats. This court simply applies the rules.
Rules both sides seem to be pushing.
The game plan today, the defense will most likely bring back Dr. William Rodriguez after the prosecution had extra time to depose him on Monday. Live at the WESH 2 Courthouse Studios, I'm Andrea Jackson, WESH 2 News.
And the clash in court is one glaring example of the defense team troubles. WESH 2's legal analyst, Judge O.H. Eaton, says he's never seen so much disorganization in a case this big.
The defense has got witnesses who have something to say. Unfortunately, the defense is so disorganized that it's close to a meltdown. I think the defense is floundering out there, and if they don't get their act together today, there's going to be problems tomorrow.
Count on WESH 2 for continuing coverage as day 24 gets underway. We will bring it to you live on air and online as soon as testimony begins at 9 a.m. this morning. Be sure to check out the extended Casey section of WESH.com for a recap and full analysis of the case.